provided design services for the Shiel Center, the Gordon Gymnasium renovation and additions, Jackson Hall renovation, and Benson Hall renovation. He's a founding member of the Grover Athletic Club, serving as president for the first 3 years of operation and as a board member from 2012 to 2017. Brian and his wife Maria, also a Grover class of 86, live in Fargo with their three kids. Tyler, a Grover class of 13, Justin, a Grover class of 17, and Kara, a Grover class of 2020, and continue to be active in the Oak Grove community. I'd like to ask Brian to come forward. And let's give it up for Brian.
Thanks, Mark. It's an honor to be here today, and a lot of people to thank, and a lot of people to recognize. I just want to have a few comments here. I'm going to keep it fairly short because the boys will kick off fairly shortly, and that's one of my other passions. So I want to thank my wife and my family, Maria, also a class of 1986, and Tyler, who couldn't be here today because he's in the marching band with NDSU. Iowa right now, so, my son Justin and my daughter Cara, who are both here today, and my mother-in-law and father-in-law, Bob and Margaret, who are here today, and then especially my mom and dad, who are sitting up there, and my brothers, Mike and Jeff, who are not here today either, but it's a tremendous honor to be inducted into the Hall of Fame, certainly unexpected, and it's just, it's really an amazing privilege to share this honor with my dad, who's also a Hall of Fame inductee. Class. My mom and dad came to Fargo when I was crawling around on the floor, and I think I was maybe 2 years old when we came to Fargo, maybe one and a half. And so I've been around here since before I learned to walk. And some of my earliest memories are centered on the campus here, going to Christmas concerts in Boston Mall, kind of right on the spot where we're standing here, or where I'm standing. Home choir concerts, seeing my dad drive off on the bus and then waiting for that bus to come back, a week or 2 weeks later with the choir kids and then going to those home choir concerts. Football games down by the river, running around in that field down there all those years. I attended elementary school at Washington Elementary in North Fargo, and I went to junior high and Franklin Junior High, but I grew up on this campus. And so it's just a really cool thing to be as involved as I am now here and to see my kids here now. I came as a freshman to Oak Grove, so I went through my elementary and junior high years in public school, and then came here as a freshman. And Oak Grove gave me an educational experience that was founded in faith and service, and that attitude of servant leadership has just grown so much here since the time I was here. It's just continued to expand. And the things that are being done here and now that I see my kids doing are really remarkable. And they're getting to have the same kind of experiences that Maria and I had when we were here. Things like going on a choir tour, and traveling on the bus to away games, and freezing because the bus doesn't have good heat, and all those kinds of things. So it's really fun building those friendships that will literally last a lifetime. This is our 30th. So Maria and I were with our class last night, and we're going to have more to our house tonight. It's just really fun to just continue to be involved. And that's one of the great things about being a Grover is you're able to be involved. It's a Class B school, that small school environment that is so important to all of us, not only the faith education component of Oak Grove, but just the ability to be involved, to be able to be passionate about music and athletics and drama and whatever you want to be passionate about all at the same time is what's great about Oak Grove. Singing in the quartet with Neil and Gerald and Peter Ive the fun times that we had, traveling around, singing in small churches around the area here, building Garrett's Temple with Jim Peoplestead, staying up all night, gluing little pieces of balsa wood bricks onto the face of that temple, kind of developing that passion for building and for architecture. But lots of great memories while I was here on the campus. Incredible teachers that were here that both Maria and I had, Mrs. Wallman, Mrs. one of our favorites. Mrs. Nielsen, Mr. Albee, who was a huge influence on everybody that ever took a class from Mr. Albee. Mrs. Lerthal, Mr. Gorder, obviously Darwin, was a huge part of my life growing up. I was around Darwin all the time when I was growing up. So, he was a very formational kind of a person around my life. Mrs. Underlocky, and campus pastor when I was a senior, Matt Pauling, who was just a great mentor, and there continue to be great mentors on campus today, and just two that I'll call out, Mr. Cortez and Mr. Noel, who are just, Mr. Cortez was a huge influence on Potter, and Mr. Noel was too, and Mr. Noel is still here, and is a huge influence on Justin and Cara. So it's great to see the things that they're doing and how they're bringing student leadership and servant leadership to a whole new level. Right after graduation, I went to basic training and really enjoyed my time in the guard. One funny story, right after graduation, like a week after graduation, my parents had a little surprise send-off party for me. And I don't know where I was, but I didn't know what was happening. They were all in the basement, all my classmates were in the basement. I came home, went flying into my bedroom, grabbed a pair, took off my clothes, I was in my underwear, and I grabbed a pair of sweats and I was going down the stairs to see them, to go watch TV or something. I got halfway down the stairs and realized that the room was empty, my underwear, and realized that the room was full of people. So that was not good. But after returning from basic training, I started at NDSU and I was there for 5 years participating in all the music groups at NDSU. And I really knew at some point during my education here at Oak Grove, I decided that I wanted to go into architecture. I'm not sure exactly when that happened, but I had friends that had dads that were architects, and I knew that I was either going to go into music or architecture. Those were really my two options. And my whole life, professional and academic and personal life, I really orbited around music and architecture in a lot of different ways. Architecture has been called frozen music by a lot of people. And if I wasn't an architect, I probably would be a music teacher, which is what my dad was and did. I guess you never stop being a music teacher. So, and it's what my son is going into, which is really, really cool. But architecture appealed to the right side of my brain, that creative side. That Zara built my left side, that analytical side, it kind of fed that as well. So I just really enjoyed that kind of aspect of education. And when I was I was a senior in college, and we had a project where we were assigned to build a sculpture of a piece that represented a piece of music, a frozen music piece. And so the piece that I selected was Box Little Fugue, and I built my sculpture based on the ratio of the fifth and the third in the opening 3 notes of the fugue there. And it was really a cool thing. It was in the lobby of the student union there for a long time, and it was really cool. But after I graduated, I started a career that got me into a lot of church projects and a lot of educational projects, and been involved in a lot of projects around the area here. St. Andrew and the Holy Cross and Hope Salt are a few that you're probably real familiar with if you're from the area here. And a lot of educational projects focusing on STEM education and active learning and a lot of really exciting things that are happening in education and architecture. So I've had the pleasure of working on a lot of schools in Region 1, which is really interesting. When you go back, I'm working right now on Central Gases Project, and they have a referendum coming up at the beginning of October. So when I interviewed for that project, it's that old rival was never die. And so when I interviewed for that project, and many of you know that Morgan Forrest, who was here for many years and then went to Shiloh for several years, is now the superintendent at Central Castle. And I went there, I knew that I had a friend in Morgan. And so I figured if they would let Morgan be their superintendent, they probably would let me be their architect. So it's been really fun working with them, and I'm looking forward to hopefully a successful project out there if that referendum passes. But the thing that I enjoy most about architecture is that collaborative environment that we all work in. We work in a collaborative world, a collaborative workplace, and I think a lot of that ability to communicate and the ability to connect with people was really planted with me here at Oak Grove. I've been blessed with great partners, Tim Zerg and Steve Gertz. They would be here today if they were here, but they're in Iowa, which is where I would be if I was here today. So We have an amazing group of co-workers in our office. We've got 25 people in our office right now, men and women, very diverse group. We've had people from all over the world that have worked for us, very ethnically diverse. We've had people from Europe and Asia and Africa and South America work for us. I think the only continent that we haven't had is Australia. And I think if I hire somebody from there, I'd probably get a free t-shirt or something. It's really been a fantastic experience working with all these people. And I enjoy mentoring young people. I enjoy being around them. And I think there's a misconception that architects just sit at their desk for all day long. And that's certainly not what I do. My day is spent out meeting with people and building teams and collaborating. So it was a great experience to be a part of the work here at Oak Grove and everything that has been done here architecturally in the buildings here. Started with a call from Darwin Gorder. There was a memorial gift that was given by the Hanset family, and Darwin said, "Can you help us design a sign for the corner?" And so, sure, that'd be really fun. So we started with that, and about a month later, it was, "Can you come up with a master plan for the campus?" So then we started talking about what a master plan would look like and what sort of things needed to be in there. And that led to the Shield Center in Jackson Hole and Gorder Gym Addition. Eventually also went to renovations in Benson Hall just was a real privilege to be involved in coming back to the campus that I grew up on and participating in those projects. So, we've been very active on campus, both my wife and I. We've got 4 years left coming this year of being parents on campus with Cara. She'll graduate in 2020 and this is our last year chasing basketball. Justin, we've been chasing basketball for as long as we can remember, going back to coaching youth basketball and just have had a wonderful experience. Some of our best memories are chasing kids, playing basketball, and ours on the Akron team, so following her around is absolutely a blast, and we'll continue to do that as we go forward here. So, just kind of closing here, a few years ago, probably 6 or 7 years ago, I think I was working on a church project, and I was trying to come up with some imagery for the project, and so I pulled out the Book of Worship, and I started searching the Lutheran Book of Worship for hymns that have a relationship to the building, foundation, and cornerstone, and all of the awesome imagery that's in the scriptural imagery that gets put into hymns. So I just made a list of them here. You know, the church is one foundation. I'll firm a foundation. Now I have a firm foundation. Behold the sure foundation stone. Christ, thou art the sure foundation. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. My hope is built on nothing less. Rock of ages cleft for me. Built on a rock the church I stand. And finally, the greatest of all Lutheran hymns, a mighty fortress is our God. So I look at the world as a huge part of that foundation. We built our life on that foundation. We've added 3 more stones to that foundation with our kids. I just love that imagery. I've used it many times in my professional career as I've worked on church projects since then. We're all the body of Christ. The church is one foundation. And the stone that the builders rejected is the cornerstone. We live in a complex, messy, screwed up, but incredibly beautiful world. And we're all so blessed to have Oak Grove in our lives. Building that foundation of faith one stone at a time. So thank you all for this honor. God bless you. God bless Oak Grove. Go Brewers and go buy some tunes.
Tracy was named to the All-Conference team 3 years in a row,
valuable player in basketball. Tracy was a two-time state qualifier in track and was named the most valuable player on the track team. During her senior year, Tracy was named homecoming queen and also received the Conant Award, given to the most outstanding female athlete in the graduating class. Tracy is not able to be with us today, but she has prepared a statement, and Becca Conant will read that statement.
When I was a student at Oak Grove Lutheran School, the beautiful atmosphere made me fall in love with autumn, and ever since my time at Oak Grove, autumn has been my favorite time of the year. Nothing compares to the beauty of our campus, the changing colors, and the excitement in the air that new school year brought. Today I enjoy getting newsletters that highlight homecoming, the fall sports and events, and picking out your classes that are for homecoming weekend. It's a very special time of year. When I opened the most recent newsletter, I certainly did not expect to see my name as one of those announced as the 2016 Hall of Fame recipient. Reading or writing for me was a pleasure and was also entertaining. It especially amused my 17-year-old daughter who thought my senior picture was comical. I really enjoyed reading and writing because it's been almost 30 years since I graduated and did not have the clearest recollection of the things that I did in high school. But as I read of the groups and clubs I participated in, it brought back many joyous memories. There are some things about high school that have left a lasting memory, such as two-a-day practices, playing basketball for Coach Conant, track practice in the park, and pet fests. Also, wondering how much of the football field would be flooded in the spring, choral club with Mr. Berg, dorm life, and the kindness and sense of humor of teachers like Mr. Carnell and Mr. Higgins. I enjoyed reading the write-ups of the other recipients. Congratulations to both of them. I knew Brian Berg, and it was great to see his accomplishments highlighted and recognized. Like Brian, I also have two children that graduated or will graduate from high school in the years 2013 and 2017. I imagine his life has been somewhat like mine, raising grandkids and family. I did not know Lizzie, but what a lovely young woman who was highly accomplished in a variety of areas. I'm sure she had an amazing experience reaching the state tournament in both of her sports. I'm guessing it's an experience she still talks about with her former teammates. So what has happened to me since high school? I stayed in Moorhead and played basketball at Moorhead State University for 2 years, and then moved to Minneapolis where I graduated from the University of Minnesota. I married the most wonderful man in the world, he told me to write that, and had two beautiful daughters. My husband, also named Tracy Martin, attended the University of North Dakota. However, he is from the Twin Cities area. He is now a detective for the Bloomington, Minnesota Police Department. My oldest daughter, Jade, is 22 and a senior at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. She plays basketball for the Waves, and she absolutely loves the university and her experiences there. My youngest daughter, Jasmine, is 17 and a senior in high school. She will be attending the University of Minnesota next year, where she will compete for the Golden Glover from volleyball team. It goes without saying that my family are the loves of my life and my greatest accomplishment. I am currently a major in the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office, headquartered in Minneapolis. We are the largest sheriff's office in Minnesota. We have approximately 1,000 employees and volunteers. I directed our Administrative Services Bureau for the past 8 years and have recently been assigned to oversee our Detention and Court Services Bureau. I really want to thank the Hall of Fame Committee for this great recognition. I'm deeply touched by this honor. Looking at the committee list, I recognize many names and remember old friends like Karen Spilley and Scott Porter. Thank you to Rebecca Conant for tracking me down. How nice to communicate with a niece of one of my all-time favorite coaches. I don't get back to the area much, but I do and will always have incredible memories of my 4 years of growth. It was such a blessing that I was able to get my high school education here. I love being a student, I love the campus, the wonderful teachers and the students, in particular the amazing class of 1987. I will forever be grateful for the Christian education and the preparation for the future that I received in the most loving and supportive of environments. So again, thank you to everyone, and enjoy this celebration.
Our last inductee, Lindsay Lightner saw success in academics, athletics, music, and leadership. She was a member of the chapel and concert choirs, as well as the National Honor Society. Lindsay was also from Homecoming Queen in 2000 and was a valedictorian for the class of 2001. Lindsay was an accomplished volleyball and basketball player. She played varsity volleyball for 5 years, was team captain for 2 seasons, and amassed numerous recognitions during her career, including most valuable player, top defensive player, top offensive player, top server, and most dedicated player. During the 98 state volleyball tournament, Lindsay was a member of the consolation championship team, and in her senior year was named the North Dakota High School Activities Association Outstanding Senior Athlete. After high school, Lindsay attended college at Colorado State University, graduating magna cum laude. She earned her Master's of Arts in Counseling Psychology from Mars Hill, and is currently working towards her PhD in counseling education and supervision at NDSU. Lindsay credits her coaches and teachers for being instrumental in forming what she believes to be a call to work with kids. Lindsay believes a strong sense of community, tradition, and faith made Oak Grove a wonderful place to grow up and thrive. The commitment and investment by teachers, coaches, and administrative staff provided me with the confidence and faith that I needed to flourish. Lindsay Lightner.
My heart for working with children and my came out of a growth. It came out of the 6 years that I was in junior high and senior high, the relationships I built, the coaches I had, the teachers I had, the principals I had. Specifically, I'd like to mention a few people that I want to thank, starting with Randy Babichek, my volleyball coach. I just want to thank him for the courage he had to allow me to play, for the kindness that he always showed in his coaching style, and for the courage he just let me, he had, and the confidence he had in me to let me play at such a young age. Thank you, Randy. Mr. Conant, he was a man who knew how to teach skills. He had a lot of fun with us. He wanted us to win, but at the end of the day, I would say that our team and us as players were much more important to him. If anyone knows Mr. Conant, he is all heart and soul. And I just want to thank you, Mr. Conant. Mr. Berg, there is no one quite like you. I admire you. You led us to excellence, and we all wanted to follow you. Your good opinion mattered and still does. Thank you for all you gave to me and to us. Mr. Langseth, we share a love for free throws and a love for shooting. We are both point guards and we like to run the show. You truly mentored me as a player and even more importantly as a person. I identified myself in you and I want to make you proud. Thank you for all you. Mr. Higgins, thank you for your joy and humor. Mr. Cardinal, you are special to me, and thank you. Mrs. Garvey, thank you for your utter commitment and the heart with which you taught. Mr. Albee, you are missed. Dr. Tuffy, thank you. Mr. Formis, thank you. Pastor Andreasen, Pastor Aaron, thank you. And thank you to my mom and dad, to my sisters, Susan and Jenna. Oak Grove would not have been Oak Grove without us in the family. And my sisters paved the path for me at Oak Grove and could not have paved a better path. Thank you to my son, Gregory Rowe, to his father, Greg Haney. And I also need to just thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus, who from a very young age has been a significant part of my life and has hopefully led my path and it will continue. Oprah, thank you for this honor, for the privilege to have and continue to be part of this family. I hope my life may honor what you have given me.
For the school year program. It's 1 John chapter 3, verse 1. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. And that just brings it all home for this entire weekend. There's probably been a long time since many of you have thought of yourselves as children. Right, Marc? But we all, that's what binds us all together. We are all children of God. Marv, class of 1946, you're a child of God. Willa Carlson, class of 1951, you're a child of God. Ryan, Lindsay, Tracy, all of us, we are children of God. And that's what binds us together. And that's what makes this place so special, is we can celebrate that. Celebrate the fact that we are all children of God. So I'm very honored to be in your presence this weekend. I'm excited for what remains this weekend. Thank you for your speeches. Thank you for coming back home. Thank you for being a part of this place. I do want to draw your attention to your program and just let you know that there is a form on the back here. I'd ask you to take some time. Think of those other rollers or faculty that need to be honored. Think of those people who have had an impact on this school that we're not thinking of. We need your help. Take the time to fill this out for us. Take the time to list the next person who should be honored by the school. Give us a hand and leave those with us today. So with that, I want to say thank you. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. Thank you so much. And one more round of